30.3 million people in the United States have diabetes, or 9.4% of the U.S. population. This comes to roughly 1 in every 11 people. An estimated 1 in 4 people do not realize they have diabetes. The economic burden of diabetes in the United States is roughly $327 billion, and adults with diabetes are at a 50% increased risk of death compared to those without. This course will focus specifically on type 2 diabetes. Type 2 diabetes occurs when hyperglycemia develops over time due to insulin-producing beta cells of the pancreas not being able to compensate for the body's insulin resistance. Certain populations are at higher risk for type 2 diabetes when compared to others. We see a higher frequency of diagnosis in African American, American Indian, Hispanic Latino, Asian American, and Pacific Islander populations. Risk for diabetes increases with age, obesity, poor diet, or a sedentary lifestyle. Higher in individuals with a family history of diabetes, elevated blood pressure, 140 over 90, low HDL, less than 35, and elevated triglyceride level, greater than 250, and a prior history of either impaired fasting glucose, IFG, or impaired glucose tolerance, IGT, and/or hemoglobin of 5.7% and above. Women with previous history of gestational diabetes and delivering a child over 9 pounds, being diagnosed with polycystic ovarian syndrome, PCOS, are also at higher risk for developing type 2 diabetes. Screening a person for type 2 diabetes begins with establishing his/her risk level. The American Diabetes Association Diabetes Risk Stratification Criteria Tool is useful for determining what tests to do initially and when to do a repeat test in the case of an abnormal result. A simple in-office screening of your patient is essential to allow follow-up with and treatment of patients who screen positive. Please download the files listed below for more details and a copy of the PDF version of the ADA screening survey. Early detection and prompt intervention are especially beneficial in the treatment and reduction in the risk of future health complications which patients with diabetes are more susceptible to. An A1C test to measure average blood glucose is one of the screening tools in the diagnosis of a patient at risk for type 2 diabetes. An A1C below 5.7% is within normal range. Between 5.7% and 6.4% is considered pre-diabetes, and 6.5 or higher screens positive for diabetes. Other screening tests, including fasting plasma glucose, FPG, and oral glucose tolerance test, OGTT, you need 2 lab tests to confirm type 2 diabetes. A FPG result less than 100 milligrams per deciliter is normal. 100 to 125 is pre-diabetes, and greater than 126 meets the criteria for diabetes. An OGTT result less than 140 milligrams per deciliter is normal. 140 to 199 is pre-diabetes, and 200 meets the criteria for diabetes. This concludes the prevalence and screening section. Please proceed to the next section of the course, which covers a high-level overview and interactive version of our Stanford Diabetes Management Algorithm.